But moving from there on, let's quickly pull up a Magma FinCorp and see what that counter is doing in trade. Let's quickly see, because Magma HDI is now looking to grow the health insurance business. 1% is the up move that we are seeing on this counter. Joining us to discuss the prospects in terms of health insurance is Rajiv Kumar Swami, MD and CEO at Magma HDI. Good morning, Rajiv. To start off with, firstly, overall, currently, if you talk about Magma HDI, a JV between Magma FinCorp and Germany's HDI Global SE, always motor and commercial insurance space where you were dealing into. Health insurance is something that you are now entering. What's the rationale behind the same?
Yeah, good morning, and thank you for having me on the show. If you look at the overall health opportunity in the general insurance space, health is about a 32,000 crore market, and this has been growing at about upwards of 20% year on year. But if you look at the opportunity set, today only about 6% of the overall health spends in the country get routed through insurance. If you look at the retail penetration, only about 4% of individuals gets covered through corporate plans, and only about 3% actually buy retail health policies. So from an opportunity standpoint, I think the opportunity is immense, and we are seeing more and more players coming into the space. There are increasing consumer needs from health insurance requirements, and if you look at it from our perspective, we've established ourselves as a fairly strong player on the motor space, and even in terms of the overall operating parameters or complaints, if you look at data from the public disclosures, we had the second lowest complaints for every 10,000 policies. So from an opportunity and a timing perspective, I think health is the next way forward for Magma HDI.
Right, so health is the next way forward, and as you mentioned, health insurance is almost a 30,000 crore industry in terms of where India is concerned. But overall, currently, if you talk about FY18, we're just probably 6 months away from the financial year closing. What contribution can you expect from the health insurance space, at least in FY18?
So if you look at our last fiscal, health and accident was virtually a non-existent portfolio in our product booking. The first 6 months, what we did was we actually launched a benefit-based product, which was critical illness. And today, that constitutes about 3.5% of our portfolio for the first 6 months. We've got our regulatory approval on the retail health product, which is an indemnity offering. And we've done a launch in the month of November. What I can say is that we intend to add about a 5% delta year on year, and I would say over the next 2 to 3 year horizon, we would expect health to be about 20% of our portfolio, motor would come down to about 60%, and the commercial portfolio would be about 20% of our book.
Okay, and currently, if I'm not mistaken, health and accident accounts for a little over 3% of your total business?
That's correct.
And how many years would it take for you to reach the 20% mark in terms of revenues from health and accident?
I would say about a 2 to 3 year horizon.
Okay. And apart from that, if you could just tell us, where does the company's gross written premium stand currently?
Financial year 2017, we had a gross written premium of 423 crores. We had a profit of about 6.3 crores. The first 6 months, we've grown by about 28%, and our premium stands at about 240 crores, and we had a profit of about 2.6 crores.
Right. And overall, Rajiv, if you talk about where, Magma is concerned, in terms of your geographical spread as well, 86 branches with a network of more than 2,000 intermediaries across the country. Are you going to be focusing mainly on the Tier 2, Tier 3 cities, or will we see something in the Tier 1, Tier 2?
So the objective is to straddle on, one, the entire Magma FinCorp distribution network. So Magma as an entity is currently present in about over 300 branches in 22 states. And as you rightly mentioned, we are present currently in only about 86% of those locations. What we've done over the last 12 months is created significant management bandwidth. We've got the intellectual horsepower. And today, I think our next phase of growth would primarily come in from deploying foot soldiers in these rural semi-urban branches. That's one end of the spectrum which would ride on the Magma distribution. Retail agency is today, in fact, our largest channel, which comprises almost 50% of our business. And from a commercial business standpoint, we've got our direct corporate sales as well as intermediated broking channels that we would rely on. And the last, which is right now a fledgling channel for us, is our bancassurance and alliances. And I'm happy to state that in the month of September, we forged our first OEM tie-up as well with a large Indian OEM, and we've started driving business through that. So our endeavor would be to be a multi-channel and a multi-product company.
Right. All right, Rajiv, pleasure speaking to you. So health insurance is the way forward. In fact, as we know, the company has already announced the launch of One Health, a health insurance plan which would cover significant medical conditions as well as lifestyle diseases like LASIK, bariatric surgery, as well as psychiatric treatments, among the others. So that's the foray, but the stock of Magma Fincorp currently as we speak at the day's low, but still trading in the positive with 0.8% higher. 1 year, 85% is the kind of return that we've seen on the counter. And in the last, on the YTD basis as well, 62% is the upside that we have seen on a Magma Fincorp. But let's quickly slip into a short break and then connect with Anurag Mundra of Ujjas Energy to know more about the impact of the recent import duty on solar equipment. Please stay tuned.